Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day.
He felt that this Jhulan was, he felt it was the full manifestation of Mayapur Dham, he was telling me yesterday. So he really appreciated. Anyway, but I want to thank everybody, because I noticed that this year, like Jhulan Das Prabhu always says, it gets better and better. But this year it was like so smooth, but only because everyone that's helping with all the service, you were like amazing, and it was like so cool. Anyway, I just want to thank everyone, because without everyone participating, this Jhulan couldn't happen. And I can't express how grateful I am, and I'm sure Guru Kirtan's equally as grateful. And anyway, but now once you do service 1 year, you're on the list, okay? So Radha Madhava have enrolled you. Anyway, thank
Krishna. I would like to officially thank Guru Kirtan Prabhu and Sharanagati Mataji for doing such a selfless service. And they are so inspiring, being there the whole day. Yesterday I came home exhausted and I asked my husband, how can Gundi do it? He's there from early morning and he's the last one to leave, he's the last one to eat, he's the last one and the first one and everything. So it's so inspiring to see the second generation devotees taking up service and being responsible. That inspires all of us and the future generations as well. So, and Sharanagati Mataji as well, like, it's always so caring and always concerned if you're feeling all right. So thank you very much.
Gurukul, so each of the ashram had their own Jhulan. And they said, you don't come to my Jhulan, you don't come to my Jhulan. So they had one separate Jhulan for everybody. And they all had their own Jhulan, plus the main one on the, where you enter the Gurukul. There's a tulsi plant in one place. This was the Jhulan area. So from the small Jhulan, it's one of the biggest festival in Mayapur. I think the third biggest festival in Mayapur right now. First is Gurpurnim, then Rath Yatra, I think now is the Jhulan. So we progressed a lot. It is not only me, it's all teamwork and also blessing of Janas Prabhu and Pankaj Janas Prabhu, their guidance, and they help us so much. Any kind of problem we have, any kind of misunderstanding, we go to them and they guide us properly what to do, how to do. So without their blessing and without the blessing of the devotees, this wouldn't be possible. Thank you everyone. If somebody has any stories, maybe you can tell something a little bit. Nobody wants to say anything. And the prasadam is on the way. Actually, we are a little late with the prasad because there is no one to bring the prasadam. So they went to get, and Pangajarpu is on the way, coming here. So in the meantime, we can have some kirtan. And then the offering is going on. So when kirtan goes on, I think after he's here, he might say something. Then we'll have prasad. Thank you.
I have one story.
Yeah, Pandava has one story. Actually, long time ago, when around 96, 95, Pandava was in Mayapur. We used to use his deities for the Jhulan. It is long time ago. Then after that, he left Mayapur for some reason. Then the next deity came. This deity we have now is Apravita Mataji. This is her deity. This is going on for a long time. Marsinga Prabhu. But before that, what Rachitamar Mata's deity also was there. So each deity took part in Jhulan festival in different years. And now Radha Madhava directly coming to the festival. Last, I think, this is the 12th year we're having Radha Madhava for Jhulan festival. Thank you.
Way back in 1996, we had a big flood in Mayapur. And it was time for Jhulan. So the devotees, the Gurukul boys, are deciding what to do. And so I had given them a suggestion that the Samadhi, Srila Prabhupada's Samadhi, had approved that they hold the Jhulan up there in that raised area around the Pukur so they could continue and have it during the flood. But they decided they wanted to have it down there. So they, all the boys, hiring the local people too, they built a dam completely around the Gurukul. They built a pile of earth and went all the way around the Gurukul, and then they...
Sandbags.
Oh, sandbags, okay. And so then they got these pumpers that they use, diesel pumpers, to flood the fields to grow the rice. So they put all these diesel pumpers inside the dam and pumped all the water out 24 hours a day so they could have Jhulan Yatra. And it was very dry in there. And so many of the Maharajas, Jai Pataka Maharaj, and Rajanjanandana Maharaj, and they would come down by boat from the... Okay. They would come down from the main temple area, from the Brahmachari ashram. They would come down by boat, and the boys be walking along outside the boat, pushing them in, bringing them all the way up to inside the dam area. And then they would come in and swing the Lord every night. It's okay. And I put this on YouTube. I have a YouTube channel we started in, my wife started in 2008, but it shows the flood and the Maharajas coming and swinging Radha and Krishna. And Vedasara Prabhu is the president of the Atlanta temple. He was a Mayapur Gurukul boy. And he would come every night by boat. And then they would come to our house and take Sri Sri Radha Madhava and on the palanquin and take them over to the boat. And then the boat would go down to the Jhulan Yatra every evening. So it was really special. A lot of people came. And you can watch that on Nimai Nittai YouTube channel. Hare Krishna. Like our ad-free videos? Be sure to subscribe to our channel. We publish new videos every day, and don't forget to like and share our channel.